good, good. Lunges, good. We talked about that. We don't necessarily have to. We've already done some of these things, but the lunges, if you can do the lunges here, the monster walks, and if you can have your hands above your head, it does what? Raises your center of gravity from where? Your belly button higher, so their balance is a little bit unstable. I like to do it so that, like Chris did, hold your position. Make sure they can hold it, because if they just do one of these, they're just gonna be going along and they're really not developing the strength that they need to, and that's a good strength builder. We talked about relay races, and just some pictures. You wanna run on hot coals, you wanna move your feet quickly, you can do that type of thing too, so we did that with the skip. All right, jump rope. How many use jump ropes? Jump ropes are good, and I like them. These are one of the things that I did with my high school practices and my middle school practices. They always did a series of jump rope things. And they did that when? That half hour before they even came on the court. And here's what we did. We've got several jump ropes here, so if anybody wants to grab a jump rope, you all want to do this, right? Here we go. Yeah, we have some volunteers.
Whoa!
Whoa. Let's hear it from my volunteers, right? Yeah. Okay, here's what you're gonna do. 2 feet, just jumping with 2 feet. Yeah, just get the feel for your new rope. How hard is this for a lot of kids that haven't jumped rope before? They have no clue. And interesting, I was, as a physical education teacher, we did jump ropes when they were in first and second grade. And you know who is the worst? The boys were horrible. Girls could do it. They were usually pretty good. So we got 2 feet. I want you to alternate feet now. So right, left, right foot, right foot, left foot. Okay, I'm just on 1 foot now. Just on 1 foot. Very nice. Very nice. On the other foot. Okay, good. Catch your breath. This time you're gonna do two rotations every time. So you're gonna really have to spin your rope quickly. This is tough.
When you call it the whole time.
I just call it double jump. So here we go. Yeah, so, and I used to have a 10 jump club and a 20 jump club. If they can do 20, two jumps, that's strength, that's agility, that's coordination, and that's endurance.
I would get the gold star.
You'd get the gold star, yeah, absolutely, right. But I would put your name up on the board as a gold star double jumper. How about, how many can you do, and I always like to do this one, how many can you jump in 15 seconds? 15 seconds, so it's a sprint. Ready? Set? Go. Oh. Ah. Come on, Serena, come on. Longest 15 seconds of your life. Time. All right. So you can track those things, but those are good to get yourself warmed up. And the last one is just a continuous jump. And I've got a 100, 200, and 300 club that we just had their names up. And if you could do 100 without a miss, how tough is that? Pretty tough. Yeah. It's pretty tough. You get tired after about 80, and then you start to get sloppy. And if you do 200 and 300, but if I get 300, I know I've got somebody. I know we're wearing our ropes out, so there we go. So we're working on some stamina there too. All right. So everybody, we're ready for some strength. How soon do we start strength? Question of the day: can you start strength with an 8-year-old kid? Yes, yes, you can. You can. But you have to be careful. You have to be careful. Have you ever seen gymnasts when they're 8 years old? They can really do, some of the good gymnasts can do some unbelievable things because they're strong and they've developed that. And most of the stuff they do with their body weight. So everybody can do these things. So here we go. Coach Kirk will just read off on the board. So where are kids weak?
Upper body.
Or we can say shoulders and core.
Shoulders and
they're weak. So we're gonna do some core and shoulder strength. And oh gosh, we just did a demonstration. And we did a few things. I had some kids that could not do a crab walk. They just couldn't, they could get in a position, but they couldn't move. I'm going, wow. Wow, I mean, it's really limiting. So here's what we have. Everybody show me your best bear walk. Your best bear walk. Go. Oh yeah. Hey, remember, best effort. Okay, good. Best bear walk backwards. Best bear walk backwards. Best bear walk in a circle. Best bear walk sideways. Okay, I want you to go a 180. I want you to, no, you're not done. Come on. I want you to do, watch this, guys. I want you to do a 360. I want you to be in a bear. I want you to go around and back to a bear without touching anything but your hands and your feet. Go.
Like 50 shades of
cat. Oh, yeah.
Like that?
Yeah.
I used to do that.
All right. Okay, how about a crab walk? Show me your best crab. Crab walk. What's a crab walk look like? This is tougher. This is tougher. How about backward crab? Sideways crab. Circle crab. A 360 crab. Yeah, you got it. Yeah, all right. Hermit crab, right. Okay, so squat walks. Here's a tough one. Tough one. Get in your squat position. Thighs are parallel, and you're going to walk forward. Yeah. Go, everybody. Everybody. Lower, lower, lower. Yeah. Okay, monster walk. We've already demonstrated the monster walk, so that's here. Let's go back the other way with a monster walk. Hands above the head, big strides. That back knee should almost, if not, touch the court. Good, and I like to hold that position just for a second to make sure we're on balance. Okay, next one is a push-up position. You're not going to do push-ups, but you're going to be in a push-up position. Yeah. Some of you people are going to wake up tomorrow morning and go, geez, man. So push-up position, and then I want you to form a T. So you're going to go up on one arm and form a T. That's it. Sharon's got it. Okay, then back, and then the other arm for a T. Oh, warning. Warning. If you're in the middle of the summer, you probably don't want to do these on a hard court. Yeah, it's kind of hot. How about an inchworm? Anybody know what an inchworm is? Right? So push up, Daniel. We're going to have Daniel do it all by himself. How many think he can do it? Okay, I want you to be in a push-up position. And then I want you to walk your feet up. And then walk your hands out. Then walk your feet up. So at one point, you're going to be in this position. And then we need to race. Yeah. Does everybody know Coach Gould?
Up here.
Yeah, I'd play for him. Okay, here you go. You're only getting your right. I've got a couple things. Let's do, Coach, you'll like this one. Where am I? Rock climber Rose with you. Okay. Let me skip this one. I need a partner. Daniel, you'll be my partner on this one. Come here. This is a fun one. Kids like this one. We're going to sit down. We're going to put our toes together. And you're gonna hold on to my hands. And we're gonna stand up. Then we're gonna sit down. Like that one? Turn around. We're going to be back to back. We're going to hook arms. Yeah. All right. Let's see if the old guy can do this one. We're going to stand up. Okay, ready? Go. Oh, yeah. With a partner, toe to toe. Go. Toe to toe, you'll sit up with your partner, just like we did with Daniel. Good job. Good job. All right. Next one, I'm going to get Daniel. I'll give you a rest this time. Yeah. We're going to do.
I got a second one.
We're going to put our feet together.
Oh, man, this is not going to be good.
Yeah, it's
going to
be good.
Yeah. My back's next.
Rag. Right. And we're going to row.
Okay.
You're going to pull me, I'm going to pull you. Go, ready? Okay, go. Yeah. 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 With your partner, go. Roll the boat.
Come on. Come on, Jason. Come on.
Yep. Another one?
Stretch the arm.
Yeah. Okay, another 10 minutes.
All right, here we go.
Got one?
Yep.
Oh, I can't.
Come on.
All right. I should do before it matches.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Good. Yeah. So, everybody right here so you can see my eyes. I've got two things on roll the boat. Pretty good. On the rim. So I've got a book recommendation. Do a lot of reading. If you've read this book, I haven't talked to anybody who hasn't thought it's a great book. It's called Boys in a Boat.
Yeah.
Anybody read it? Really, really good book. Row the boat. Who used row the boat? What football team used row the boat?
Western Michigan.
Come on. What?
Western Michigan.
Western Michigan. Where did Kirk Anderson go? Western Michigan. You're right. So Western was 13-0, right? They had two undefeated teams that played college football. They got beat in the Cotton Bowl. But the coach is unbelievable. He went to Wisconsin. He just went to
Minnesota.
And he was in USA Today yesterday. Because they're letting him use row the boat. But that was his whole thing. You know, we row the boat, what do we do? That means everybody pulls every time, every play, help each other out. Pretty cool. He's gonna be successful. He's a crazy guy, but he's got a lot of energy. 35 years old, he's got a Big Ten job. So here we go. Row the boat. All right, here we go. Coach, we gotta show him some good stuff here. Oh yeah, here we go. You can do things with body weight and everybody's got a pair of shoes, or you can use tennis rackets. I've got a couple things, but you can do side, right? And if you do these long enough, you're going to get a workout, right? So with kids, they're 12 and under, you can do forward. You can do arm curls up. You can do arm curls down.
Can you use one of the bands?
You can use the tube or the bands are good. Uh-huh. Those are good. Yeah. Uh-huh. But you have to have orange shoes.
You have to have the orange.
Yeah. Good. Another one. You see these at health clubs. Have you ever seen these big, thick ropes? People do those kind of, you know? You can go to Home Depot and you can get some that aren't quite as thick and they are just as good for kids. Right? You have to spend like 10, 12 bucks to get them, but they're pretty cool. And the kids love to do that stuff? Yeah, and they're really working their shoulders. It's very dynamic and it works them pretty good. So there we go. 16, 17, 18, forearms tracking. Good. Next one, you need a partner. You need a partner and you need one tennis ball. Partner, one tennis ball. Introduce yourself to your partner and you're going to be facing me again. We doing for time? Okay, we're good. Okay, I have, and we're gonna bang through these, but I've got, and this is pretty important, and you've got to do this with little kids. You have to do this because we're gonna talk about tracking and catching. If they can't track and catch, there's no way they're gonna rally. There's just no way they're gonna rally. You can stand them up and have them hit a stationary ball, which is good, but what's fun? Hitting a ball back and forth. What's fun for you when you play tennis? Hitting a ball back and forth over a net. Am I correct? Yep. Now, most everybody says, yeah, I got to build it. So that's the race. People say, well, it's the race to the yellow ball. It's the race to what? No, it's a race to rally. Our job is to get them to rally as soon as we possibly can. If they can't rally, how long are they going to keep coming back? They aren't. Right. So we need to get them to rally. So we need to do some tracking skills. And so I've got some, and we'll blow through these things, but they're kind of fun for little kids, and they learn a lot. And if you can't track, you can't catch. We're going to teach you how to track. We're going to teach you how to catch. We're going to teach you how to throw in the next 10 minutes. Good? Yeah. Okay. And we're going to teach you how to toss and throw, underhand toss and overhand throw, and give you the mechanics on how you do that. All right. So the first one, tracking. Jason, you want to be my partner on this one? Yeah. Right. Jason's pretty excited, right? So we're going to move you right over here so everybody can see him. Right? I got to like it because he got a smile on his face. I'm going to move you over here so that racket's not in the way. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to roll a ball. I'm going to use the wall. I'm going to roll a ball, and Jason's going to have to move sideways so the ball goes right through his feet. How many think Jason can do this first time? All right, Jason's going to be in his best ready position. Here we go. And then you're going to turn around and roll it back, or toss it back. Uh-huh. Okay. Good. So he's got that. He's pretty good. But is that realistic with tennis? Not really, because sometimes it's further away and you have to do what? You can't just shuffle and hit. You've got to do what?
Run.
You got to run and hit. How many think Jason can run and hit? One person. through your feet. You got the idea. You were there, but you're going to have to run, right? Run. I need two more people. Quick. Two people. One, two. Straight line, right in front of Jason. Okay. So that was tunnel ball. This is team tunnel ball. Here we go. This time I'm gonna roll a ball and it's gotta go through all three. Can you see? Figure it out. And I can get kids to do that for a long time. If I just had them going side to side, they'd get tired of doing that after how many times? Like twice. Good. Well done. Good job, Jason. Good. All right. So that's some tracking. Roll and move ball, we'll get that. Beach ball, I've got a beach ball. You can just have them hit a beach ball back and forth. Right? If you're an indoor court, you can use, with really small kids, you can use balloons. Can they track a balloon? Yeah. One bounce, two bounce. Chris, all right, you're going to catch this ball. I'm going to say one or two, and you're going to have to catch the ball after one or two bounces. All right? How many think you can do it? Two. One, two, he catches it. One, two. How's that intensity? One. Two. Another demonstration. Rush, you're my demonstrator this time. You need two rackets. Two rackets. You can use mine. You've all done this one before, right? This is a lobster trap, right? Again, it's a tracking thing, but, catching. What about, come on in here, let's talk about catching, because this one comes up all the time. Because if I'm tossing a ball to Yusef, he catches it, and is that good? A lot of times players say, Kirk, that's not right. You never hit a ball from here. I go, yeah, I get that. So what's the problem there? All right, so eventually we want to catch the ball to the side because that's where we're going to hit it. But if you're a little kid, I want you to catch it. And that midline is where you're going to catch it. And if I roll a ball, and it's really interesting, we talk about with the progression with kids, you start the bigger the ball, the smaller the kid. And the faster the ball, the bigger the kid. A rolling ball is easier to catch than a bouncing ball. A bouncing ball is easier to catch than a ball in the air. So those are the progressions. So if I roll a ball to Yusef, he's going to do, if he's 3 years old, how is he going to catch this ball that I roll to him? So be in your best ready position, and how's he going to do it? It's not that way. The kids are going to do what? They try to smother it. And when do they go down to catch the ball? When it goes past them. So it happens all the time. So we and those same people say, Kirk, they got to catch the ball on the side. I'm going, you got to be kidding. They can't catch it in the first place. Let's catch it at the midline first and then catch it to the side. Right? So I've got Mr. Ross. He looks like what? A lobster, right. Yes, yeah, very good. He looks like a lobster. And I'm going to toss the ball, and I want to create some movement. So he's going to catch the ball between his rackets. You all done this one before? I'm going to give you three different variations of lobster catch, right? So I'm going to toss the ball, and he's going to move over. He's going to catch it, and no matter where I toss it, then what I want him to do is on the first one, I'm going to get three variations. The first one, you're going to put the ball down on the court, and you're going to roll it back with either forehand or forehand, depending on right or left. The second time I toss it, you're going to drop and hit it. The third time is stage three, and that's using your body rotation to throw it back. Got it? It's a lot to, so I'll guide you through this. So you trap it, he's trapping it side, he rolls it, perfect.
Okay. You 3-year-old.
Right. Edit that film, right? Okay, we're gonna drop and hit this time. Good. And then rotation, toss it right back to me so I can catch it right at my chest. Good.
Yeah. Oh. Yeah.
Same thing. Right. So we're going to roll the ball back and forth. So these are little kid stuff. We're going to roll the ball back and forth, but we're going to trap it with our foot. And then roll it back. Trap it with your foot. It's okay. I'm a trained professional. Then trap it with your racket. Good. Good stuff. Good stuff. I love these. I love these. Next one. Put that in your pocket. We're not done. Little kid stuff. Again. Koosh ball. So, you know, although the koosh ball pass. So here we go. Drossi, come on in here again. And how soon can you start with a koosh ball with a little kid? Yeah, two. I mean, they're 2 years old, and we can do this. In fact, yeah, we used to do this up in a playroom with my grandkids. And they thought, they would say, Papa, can we play tennis? They thought that was what tennis was, right? Because they didn't know what tennis was. But we're passing back and forth.
Start of a rally.
How can we make this more difficult or challenging?
Oh.
So, fun stuff you can do with Koosh Balls. I always like to do the top 10 Sports Center. Ross is going to make the top 10 plays of the day. How's he going to catch this? Not like this. That doesn't make the top 10. He's thinking about it. Ready? Yeah, he's got it. He's got it. He's choking up on his racket. I like he's thinking. Right. Here it is. That would have really been top 10 if he catches it right there. Right? I think he can do it. I think he can do it. But again, do you do these things with kids? I do, because they love it. They love it. How long do you spend on it? 45 seconds, and then you move on. Right? Oh, here's another thing. Come on in here. How long? So with kids, and we're talking small children now. We're talking kids that are like 8 and under. Right? How much variation do you need from lesson to lesson? Not much, if any. If they find something they like, they want to do it over and over and over again. How many have kids? Grandkids, nephews, nieces, whatever. How many times have you read a story to them? The next night, they do what?
Can we hear the same story?
Can we hear the same story? The next night.
Same story.
The next night. You're climbing the wall. Right? But they want to hear the same story. They like that familiarity. So we tend to be really creative with little kids, and we change things all the time. We don't have to. If they like koosh ball catches, do koosh ball catches every day. Because they do it, is it beneficial? Yeah, it's helping them out. And you don't have to be all that creative. You just say, hey, they like that. Make a note of that. They'll do that one again. And they'll do that. With adults, yeah, you can be a little bit more creative. But there's some value in a familiar type of activity. Koosh balls. The only bad thing about koosh balls is they're expensive. If you can find them at the dollar store, buy everything you can get. Because they're like $6, $5.95, something like this. And we're going to do a pocket check before you leave. All right. Scott's going. All right. So good stuff. Good stuff. Here we go.